What is life on Earth anyway? Heaven letter number 5579. March 4, 2016. My children may consider life on Earth as a rite of passage, as a canoe ride down a river, as a trek through a jungle, fraught with unexpected danger. My children may consider life on Earth as a ride on the carousel, as a dance floor, a Broadway musical, a feat of great dimensions. What can life on Earth not be considered as? What you consider life to be makes a difference to the life you experience. The preponderance of your thoughts about life are trendsetters. Your thoughts create a map for your life to follow. It is safe to say that whatever you consider life to be, life will still have a few surprises for you. Life really doesn't let you sit still, or life makes you sit still when you don't want to, or life on Earth makes you move when you would like to sit still or even hide. You would say that life is contrary. Life doesn't object. It is you who objects to life. Life doesn't take offense. You do. Sometimes you take offense right and left. Sometimes life can't please you. You find it difficult to be pleased. You may not really know what you want from life. What can life do to suit you when you may see life as a precarious adventure, or, even, unforgivable? You could sail down the Nile serenely. Mosquitoes could appear or asps. Fear could collar you. Anything could happen. A nice surprise is okay in your book, but not just any old surprise, but only surprises that appeal to you. Oh, how you would like to pick and choose and have the privilege of sending certain surprises in life back. How you would like to determine your life. Beloveds, there is a sense in which you do determine your life. There may well be patterns in your life that you set yourself up for lavishly. You say you would never choose these patterns, yet you may reactivate them again and again. You may be aghast at them, yet you revive them time and time again as though you were in a trance. There may well be some aspects of your life that seem illegal to you, yet you ring a bell calling them to you. You set your own traps and fall into them. You complain about them over and over again and call yourself a victim and other people to blame, or you hold me responsible. You are not able to let responsibility fall on you. You may require yourself to be a sensitive victim when you are the culprit. Life does not always seem fair, yet you are the one who deals the cards. You can be accountable. Be accountable. Accountability is not blaming yourself. It just so happens that you are the one who keeps tripping over the same potholes and are astonished. You trip yourself up. Are your shoes to blame? Your tricky footwork? How could it be that you would attract the same or similar situations in life and be bewildered? You have yet more to find out about yourself and familiar situations you find yourself in. We could say that you take certain pills that make you jumpy, yet you don't connect the pills with your jumpiness. Yes, my darlings, often you set yourself up and don't see it. Someone else can see what you are doing, yet you do not see yourself walking the same way again even as you are walking the same way and yet do not see. You follow a trail of crumbs that you have followed before and don't remember. There is something you are not seeing. Don't get all fraught with this. Just be open to the possibility that a change within you as to how you interact with the world can change the world you interact with. Just be open to this. Look. See. Follow the trail to a pattern you see, and, then, change it. Channeled by Gloria Wendroff. Heavenletters.org